Good day, fellas. I hope you are ready for your daily dose of skill, and today we are going to play with a budget tier 9. Why budget tier 9? Answer is very, very simple, because budget is still top of the tree and maybe some people will have a hard time dealing with this vehicle. So maybe some tips and tricks are going to be handy, right? I had one battle before, and I can tell you that. Have you ever had mines losing spawn when the battle is literally a couple of seconds and you are losing 15-1? Yeah, that was the game. So we will pretend it never ever existed and we are starting everything fresh, right? So without further ado, let's go into the game. And pretty much budget is a very, very, very beautiful tank in my opinion, especially when the gun handling is working good. And usually gun handling is working good on this tank whenever you are shooting APCRs. Yep. Standard ammunition of the budget AP is definitely not the finest one, but whenever you are going with APCRs, it's way, way, way better. I know. Oh, world just changed. Standard ammunition is not very good and gold is. Well, the thing is, I will try to show you a couple of games with the standard ammunition, and then we will probably go for one gold round ammunition and to check out how the things are going to look like in general, right? By the way, one thing, I am recording this video after the stream, right? So if you will see my brain lagging, I sincerely apologize. It is already 2 in the morning for me, so my brain can be a bit mushy. So I yearly apologize for that. So without further ado, let's do something very, very, very bad for the enemies. And first of all, I believe we are going to start everything from this position here. Why so? I believe this is pretty damn good position to start everything, or maybe not. You know what? There is another alternative option which we could use, and to go up here and clip someone which is going up. So it actually depends what do we want to do. You know what? I made a decision. Let's go and clip someone here. Absolutely. I think that position should work just well. And plus on top of that, we will have some bushwankers which is going to help us. For example, ISU, T95, another ISU. So it should be beautiful. At least that's what I hope for. I'm asking for our team to pre-aim here. And maybe they are going to shoot mother truckers, which is getting spotted here. And obviously this is STG. That's completely fine, fellas. My driving is sucking a massive PP. Once again, well deserved. All good. Everything is fine. And here we go. A bit of the assisting damage, which is always nice and always welcome. Luckily, we reacted properly before Arta actually eliminated us from the game, right? So we are feeling pretty damn good. Very, very nice. Good. Very good. So the start is simple, even though we did not receive that much. Even though we have zero damage, we got a bit of the assisting damage, which would be 700 in this situation, because from this side you can actually kind of easily counter people which is playing here. And that's the whole point of this scout run which I have made there. And once again, I just simply feel like it is working pretty damn good. Now we are punishing the Mr. STG. I believe he is not feeling too happy about his decisions and his choices. That's another shot for T30. Even though we are spotted, I don't really mind too much, because now I am simply going to escape and I'm going on the reload. Why so? Because I am feeling a bit paranoid to peek once again and only having 2 shells in the magazine. That's not looking too great of the deal for me. So we are simply going on the reload. Once again, no rush. We have all time in the world of tanks, and all we need to do, we need to wait until enemies will make one or another shitty ass decision. And speaking about shitty ass decisions, fellas, I don't really think enemies have more forces here. So what that means? That means we are going to make a pressure for the ISM. But first of all, we kind of want to wait until he is going to shoot, although, oh, that's perfect timing. He just fired, so all we need to do, we need to clip the living hell out of him, and he's going back to the garage, beautiful. And now we kind of need to escape, or at least attempt to escape. Very, very, very nice. Now look, our T95 turtle, he will try to make a bit of pressure like this. This is exactly what I want to see, and we should be kind of alright. And once again, the poor STG is thinking, oh my bananas. At least that's what I would think if I would be him. Obviously he's trying to run for his life, which is completely understandable. And we will try to overcut him for running for his life, right? That would be pretty damn good. That's one in the face, beautiful. We know someone is sniping from here because he just bounced and now we can escape and reload fully. So we will have a very full clip. Nice, beautiful. So far we did everything properly, at least in my opinion. Whenever we are going to about to reload, what we are going to do, we are going to eliminate the board and this guy by moving like this. I think this could be a pretty damn good strategy. Meanwhile, Leopata and Dede Fede, I have a feeling they are sniping towards us, right? Which is not ideal for our team for obvious reasons. Although, speaking about ideal, not ideal, there is a Char Footer which is going through the middle of the field. Unfortunately, once again, we did not manage to penetrate him, but we are feeling pretty damn good because we are going to protect our T95, especially if Char Futur will try to make a hardcore pressure on him, which is extremely possible, right? So once again, we are close, and if the Char Futur is going, Char Futur is getting banged. Our team is winning by humongous amount of HP already. And I believe that makes sense. Meanwhile, Borat is saying, I will flank. And I'm saying, yep, you did. Beautiful. Very nice flank. Meanwhile, fellas, Char Futur wasted couple of shots in the magazine. This is exactly what I want to see. And now we are going to be a bit more involved here, which is exactly what we need. So 1, 2, 3. He is not very happy. Beautiful, very nice. So once again, we are going for another reload, and in this kind of situation, everything worked ideally for us. I cannot say a single bad thing what we have done in this battle. I think our reaction is pretty damn top-notch. I think the decisions, obviously, which we made in this battle is also pretty damn good. So everything what we have done here is working pretty damn well. Meanwhile, Leopata is getting slaughtered. Very nice. Exactly what we need. The next victim is going to be Char Futur for obvious reasons, or ELC even. But probably Char Futur it is. So let's go for a Char Futur, right? Did he escape it yet? Yes, no, yes, and absolutely no. Beautiful. He is not prepared for us, and we are simply slaughtering him. We are taking his life and we are smiling a bit. Meanwhile, this guy, I think he just missed. Oh, yes, indeed. Now he missed. We have 3 in the magazine. And fellas, dinner, chicken, winner. Skill, have you was watching PUBG? No. I'm sorry. I was watching Viva La Viva, or however it's called. Bloody Comedian guys, and they are amazing. So, yeah. Don't mind me if I do. Okay, beautiful. Look, I am feeling extremely happy with this game. I think even though my brain is farting quite a bit now, I think we are playing pretty damn well and we deserve a big fat brother in arms, maybe? Nah, unfortunately we did not deserve it, brother in arms. Oh well, definitely well expected. I could rig them earlier, obviously. Anyways, 4,300 damage, 1,000 assisting damage, if I'm not mistaken. Very great battle in general, and everything went well. Obviously, with this tank, like with any other, you can finish with shitty ass game. For example, when you are not spotting anything and when you are not doing any damage whatsoever, it can happen, fellas. You cannot escape from this, obviously, right? So once again, pretty damn good game. I'm happy we are on top by the experience and by the damage, and once again, it was a solid game. So now, without further ado, what we are going to do, we are going to go for the other game with a budget AP. And how about if we would repeat the score? Yep, I would love to see a 6. I am okay with a 3,000. 3,000, fellas, is exactly what we are looking for. Yeah, that sounds reasonable. Reasonable it is. Okay, how we could start this battle? I could go on top of the hill and I could clip someone, which would make sense, fellas. And I think this is exactly what I'm going to do. So, without further ado, we are making a decision and we are going to go on top of the hill. Hopefully, we will have enough support there. What do we have on top of the hill, first of all? We have MLT, VP, obviously Type 61 and T95. Really? Holy bananas from Banana Land, fellas. Holy bananas from Banana Land. This T95 will probably take probably full battle to go on top of the hill, but hey, it is his decision, right? What we might meet from the enemy team. There could be multiple guys, for example, obviously enemy light tank. Ooh, budget AP, hello there. This is exactly what we want to see. This is exactly what we want to see, fellas. So Bachet AP was obviously over-aggressive and well-deserved to get slaughtered here. Another one. What the flying F is happening in this game? Boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, what the flying F is happening in this game? This is absolutely madness. I repeat, this is absolutely madness. Don't mind me if I do. See ya. If I'm not mistaken, this is a perfect clip. Meanwhile, look at this. Our meatball is saying, I'm coming! Okay, let's give him a bit of the ride. Ride of his life. Давай, 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 давай. Let's go. Okay, let's try to push the T95 on top of the hill. Since we are reloading, we are either way not the most useful dog in the field, right? And the T95 can actually help us quite a bit because he will have quite a bit of HP. And either way, I would say we are winning the this side, at least in my opinion. At least that's what I want to believe. So let's see. Okay, T95 is stopping here. T95, could you please let me go? Thank you very much. Beautiful. We have the standard V, which is trying to clip our guys. And I have a feeling he doesn't have too many in the magazine. What that means we are going to clip the living hell out of this guy for obvious reasons, right? And you cannot blame me. Speaking about cannot blame me, he is dead. Excellent. How about this T10, which is playing here? Oh, look at this. That looks like a fresh meat for us, right? And one more, pretty please. And you know what? One more. Why the heck not? Ay, ay, ay. I shouldn't shoot him once more, but we are okay. All good. We have 2,700 damage and some assisting damage. Aka tracking damage doesn't really change anything. I am feeling pretty damn good. And what we are going to do now, I believe... I kind of want to eliminate the IS-7s or Favas or whoever is playing here in the banana. I think this could be pretty damn strong and good battle by us. So what we are doing, we are trying to make a turn like this and let's see whenever they are going to make a mistake. And believe me, they will. And believe me, they will. Wait, wait, wait. Wait, IS-7 is trying to be a bit more aggressive, and here we go. Oh! My mistake. That was absolutely disgusting, my mistake. So what have I done wrong here? I decided to peek, even though I saw the Favova spotted here, and I knew he might wait for us here. But once again, mistakes were made. I deserve this. In the same time before the battle, I asked it, so can I do 3000? And the game said, exactly, you will do 3000, not more than that. Okay, let's teleport into the other game and let's see. Hopefully the third game will be the best and we will go with a full APCRs for a last game to show the potential and how fast shells are traveling, right? So let's go without further ado. And we are back, fellas. Victory. I'm happy with this game. And yeah, mistake which I made here was not the finest one, but fellas, well deserved. We can't do anything about this, right? So far, honestly, fellas, I can put the hand next to the heart. Games which we had, we are pretty good. Obviously, the second game was it was in the range of okay. So here we go, that's what we have. By the way, the main reason why enemies lost the upper side and the hill was because they were way too aggressive. That was the main problem. By the damage, we are top 4, which is okay. By experience, we are top 4. I am pretty damn happy. So, without further ado, the last but not least game, well, actually the last game and hopefully the best game is going to be with a full APCRs. Why so? Because this tank is shining the most whenever you have this ammunition. And yes, I prefer myself to play with the majority of APs and use APCRs when you actually need it, right? But in the same time, I can highlight the tank is just simply straight up better with a full gold, right? And I'm not afraid to say so, and I will try to show you what this vehicle is all about. Obviously, if I won't fail. If I will fail, then that means I will fail. What is the best start for us to start this battle? This is the biggest question. Okay, the main plan probably will be to take this position right here, and hopefully we can spot some people which is going like this, and maybe even shoot them when obviously we are going to finish reloading. So let's see, can we do this? Also, if we are going to meet the enemy living train, it can be very sad ending for us. So keep this in mind. Okay, so far, fellas, we cannot spot absolutely anything. That means it is extremely weird game. Speaking about spotting anything, there is two Panteras which is going through the open field. There is one tracked. He knows I am the one which is shooting him, but I don't really care about this. And Pantera is going home. Very unlucky and... yeah, that was a big fat mistake by those two guys. Now listen, what they have done differently and what they have done badly here, they decided to cross through the middle of the field, and that was the biggest and the fattest problem which they could make, and the biggest mistake which they could make, and obviously they made it, as you can see yourself. So once again, not the ideal choice by those guys, but it is how it is. From this magazine, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, we hit 5 out of 6 shells. The shell velocity is extremely good, and accuracy is pretty damn impressive too. It is not like you can't hit absolutely anything and you are feeling like a big pile of poop with this vehicle. It is not the case, and I believe it is worth to highlight. Speaking about what do we want to do in this game, now I'm completely changing flank and I'm going over there. Why so? We have some support in the back, we have Borat, we have Vaza 120, so I kind of want to be a bit more involved, I want to be more involved into this game, and hopefully we can make it work. Meanwhile, we have the Conqueror, which is sniping from the back or playing hold down in the middle of the nowhere. And once again, that's understandable. And what we have and what we can do, we have the E100, which is trying to side scrap there. I like side scrapping E100s. That looks pretty damn good. Can we hit him once again for sake of love? Here we go. 3 out of 3 shells, that was pretty damn good, and I decided to simply finish my journey, right? I want to reload and I want to have a full clip. One more thing which is extremely strong and extremely good whenever you are playing with an autoloader tanks, when you have only one type of ammunition, and in this kind of situation when ammunition is just simply better, right? It doesn't matter how many shells you have. What do I mean by saying that? Imagine that you are playing with a budget, there is end game, you have 2 gold shells and 3 standards left. Yeah, it is a very tricky situation to be in. And whenever we are thinking about what we are having now, right? Now when you have only one type of ammunition, you don't F your brain with this kind of nonsense. You have one type of ammunition and you are using one type of ammunition. If you are feeling like you cannot do anything for a couple of for 10 or 20 seconds, right? You are simply reloading, and this is the right way to play with autoloaders. And once again, for me, it is just a highlight. When I market budget AP, I market it with a standard ammunition. But once again, to say this is the best way to play with a tank is not a crime, don't you think so? Anyways, if you would pay attention at that T49 is saying eat shit, and he can yell as much as he wants, he is dead. 3 out of 3, you see the accuracy of this vehicle? And I'm not aiming that smooth now, I am a bit tired, and I believe you can see that from my eyes. Maybe you can see that, maybe not, but I'm not afraid to say so. Anyways, how we can approach the enemies now? This is the main and the most important thing. I'm actually thinking about making a bit of pressure. Okay, Conqueror is sniping from to the other side. We don't care about the Conqueror. What do we care about? We care about the this guy, right? So here we go. He's trying to ram us. Good luck ramming us. It's not going to be so easy. And you are dead. Beautiful. I bounced once. Actually, maybe even twice. Not entirely sure. Yes, I bounced once. That's okay. And Udes shot us twice, and both of the times he high rolled. But hey, shit happens. Doesn't really matter, because this is a victory either way, right? T-54 is saying I will help you, and that would be much appreciated if he would go, you know? If he would go first, that would be much appreciated. But as you can see, it is not looking like it is the case. So what we are going to do, we are going to go in front ourselves, and we are going to take one for the team. By doing this, doesn't really change anything, and we are okay. Meanwhile, we are going on the reload, because we can afford this. And after that, what we are going to do, I believe we are going to go for the last guys, which is sitting here. No shit, Sherlock. Skill, you are going for the last people here. Absolutely, we are. And hopefully we can get a bit more. Obviously, now I'm down to one-shotable for a majority of the tanks. For example, 1-2, Charioteer, and even EBR, I'm clippable. But it's not changing the fact we can get... at least I hope we can get one more clip from all this. Obviously, maybe making a pressure ourselves, maybe this is not the best thing. Maybe I could simply wait until our guys will make pressure, right? And then we could get a bit more damage, right? Okay, speaking about a bit more damage, this guy is completely roasted. Beautiful. How about if we would cross like this? This is a risky thing, but I'm up to take the risk. Very, very nice. Beautiful. We are prepared for everything. Now we are waiting for a couple of more seconds, and after that we are going to go to this bush. We are in the bush, and here we go. The poor Pantera is saying, please don't kill me. And I'm saying, nyom, 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 one more. Beautiful. And you know what? 1-2 TM still should be somewhere here. I really doubt he's sitting right there next to the red line. So yes, you can see he's pretty damn close. Russia. Beautiful. We hit him, but we did not manage to penetrate him. So, fellas, you can see how much more simple game with a full APCR is. It is just way, way, way easier. At least I can feel the massive difference, right? And in the end of the day, we finished with a 5,100 damage and 2,300 assisting damage. Remember, Vachet is one of my favorite tanks, or it used to be one of my favorite tanks, so I have experience how to play with it. And if I can give you at least a bit of my experience to you, then it is very, very good, and that's what I am looking for, right? So speaking about the last game, 5,100 damage, 2,000 assisting damage, 1,400 base experience, which is pretty damn good, and we lost 4,000 credits by spamming full APCRs. By the way, speaking about the hits, we hit 21 out of 21, and we did not penetrate at the 3 shots. So if we would penetrate those shots, there is a chance we would even make profits, as wrong as it sounds. So yeah, It is not that expensive to play with a tank, right? So in the end of the day, our session is solid 4,000 damage and 1,500 assisting damage. Call me dirty, call me disgusting, but I think it is extremely good game and we made it work. So fellas, even though skill is tired as F, we still managed to make it work. If you enjoyed the video, feel free to smack one of those because that helps channel out a lot. And thank you very much for watching. That was your daily dose of skill and see you very soon. Skill is out. Peace. Pachoo!